Hi folks, welcome back. This is Mike from Liquid Audio in Perth, looking at a lovely customer's Luxman 507X, SQ-507X. It's a beautiful Luxman solid state amplifier from the 70s with typical excellent Luxman build. Let's start here looking at the power supply. I've got a really big transformer here for what is, you know, a fairly low powered amp. Two big filter caps, proper screw terminals, that's what we like to see. It's all heavy duty stuff, and of course they measure perfectly. Got a preamp board there, tone control board here, and something else underneath, just some switching. Have a look at all the wiring though. Beautiful point-to-point wiring on all of these lovely switches. These are superb quality switches. The sort that you find, not so much that pot, that's not really that great, but these switches are really superb, the sort of things you find in test and measurement gear. And I know because I own a lot of test and measurement gear. what else have we got? Yeah, the wiring itself. Very, very nicely done. It's all color-coded and it's all shielded. So, you know, really, really nice. Then we've got these amplifier modules. These are the lovely modules that Luxman often included in these older amps. You can see them both there. I've removed them. With these, what I'll be doing is I'll just be going through and refurbishing these. So we'll remove and replace probably all of the small electrolytic capacitors. And I'll probably remount the output devices on silicon thermal washers. You can see that they all look very nice. I think they've been replaced, but they've been replaced with matching parts, which is good. I think those are the original parts. I'll consult the schematic shortly. But yeah, very nice Luxman amp, and I'm hoping that this will come up really well after a kind of a mini overhaul. So I'll do a little bit more in a bit. Okay, welcome back. This is part two of the very, very pretty Luxman SQ-507X service. I'd call this a service. It's like a mini overhaul. The customer complained about, you know, there were loose controls. Everything here was noisy and, to be honest, disgustingly dirty as well. Internally, it was foul, absolutely foul. But anyway, let's have a quick look at this lovely little Luxman SQ-507X. Big power transformer, two big filter caps, those are fine. I've basically overhauled these two amplifier modules. So what I've done with these, removed the modules, removed the circuit boards, replaced all the small filter caps, the small electrolytic caps. And there's really only two or three per board that I've replaced. That one there, that one down there, and there's another one which I just can't immediately, oh yeah, in between those two, right there. I've done that on both boards. You know, a lot of people will say, oh, well, you should recap the whole thing. No, look, that's just nonsense. I've measured all of these and they're perfect. They're actually as good or better than a lot of the new caps that I could fit. So there's sort of no point in recapping them unless the customer says to me, hey, look, I'd really like you to completely overhaul and restore this, in which case, yeah, I'd do that. But this was just a service. This was not within the scope of what the owner wanted me to do. So that explains that. So two modules reinstalled, adjusted the bias current for both and the DC symmetry for the control down there. Now, on the main board here, I didn't do a lot, again. I mean, I've left all of these larger electrolytics. I've left all the tantalum electrolytics. The only ones I've changed are these input coupling 1 microfarad capacitors because they were, you know, they measured quite high for ESR. So I've replaced those with some nice premium Panasonic audio grade couplers, which works very, very well. This amp now performs perfectly. So this just shows really that, you know, within the scope of repairs, you know, you have different ranges in which you might operate. So for example, a customer might say, look, all I really want you to do is to service this and get it back to working condition, which is what we've done here. You know, it's far less than a full restoration, of course. And if I was doing a full restoration, then yeah, sure, I might replace most or all of the electrolytic capacitors inside the unit. But in this case, as I said, it didn't fall within that scope of repairs and light service. But so the other things I did, I completely cleaned the fascia, as you can probably tell. You can probably tell if you compare it to the start of the video. Now I've got to obviously put this back in its wooden box. had to replace the little on lamp. That blew actually while I had it, so replaced that. And really everything else has come up very, very well. So I might do a very quick final video with it back in its lovely wooden case, because that's worth having a look at. So just bear with me and I'll do that. And there she is, all finished, buttoned back up. What a lovely amp, the SQ-507X. Typical Luxman, very, very nicely put together. And, you know, it has that classic vintage look. I mean, how's this case? Now, a question that comes up, people do sometimes ask me, Mike, what do you do to the cases? Because they always look really nice when you finish with them. Well, good question. I usually clean them with a special cleansing, a very gentle cleansing soap, and then I oil them. So that's what I've done here. And you can see all around these edges and things, looks really nice. You know, there are a few little dings and scratches that you get with age, but overall I think you'll agree, look, it's come up very, very well, as has the front panel. All the knobs and things have come up really nicely, and really everything here looks fantastic. So I'm going to write this one up and get her back to her owner. I'm sure is quite excited to get her back into the system. So yeah, that's the Luxman SQ507X. If you've got any Luxman gear or any other fine vintage classic hi-fi equipment you'd like me to have a look at, you live in Perth, Western Australia, or anywhere in Western Australia really, you're very welcome to make contact with me. You can get to me via my webpage, liquidaudio.com.au. Thanks for watching.